As a parent myself, it can be concerning if your baby or child has a rash and you don't know what's causing it. So in this video, I'm going to cover 17 different types of rashes and skin changes in babies and children so that you're able to better recognise them. Now, I'll mainly show you photos on different skin types to help you better recognise the issues, and because we'll be covering a lot of different causes of skin changes in this short video, I'd encourage you to check out the NHS website for information on treatment as well as when to see your health provider about the specific skin rashes that we're going to cover. Finally, at the end of this video, I'll cover when you should seek more urgent medical attention if your child has a rash. Now, the first cause of a rash in children is something called slapped cheek syndrome. Now, this often appears as a rash on the cheeks with a high temperature, a sore throat, a runny nose, as well as headaches, and it looks like this. Now, slapped cheek syndrome can usually be treated at home, and treatment typically involves managing symptoms with rest, fluids, as well as pain relief medication that you can get from the pharmacy if you need to. Now, the next cause of a rash in children is from a condition known as hand, foot, and mouth disease. Now, this is caused by a viral infection, and it typically causes blisters on the hands and the feet, as well as the mouth, and it causes ulcers inside the mouth, which can look like this. Again, hand, foot, and mouth disease can usually be treated at home with rest, fluids, and pain relief, which you can get over the counter from your pharmacist. Now, the next common reason for a rash in children is a heat rash. This is very common, and it's typically a rash of small raised spots that feels itchy or prickly, which gives it its commonly used name, prickly heat rash. Now, heat rash can usually be treated at home by keeping the skin cool and dry and wearing loose clothing. You might also notice scaly or cracked skin on your child that looks like this. Now, this is eczema. It's common behind the knees, elbows, and neck, but it can appear anywhere. For more information on eczema, including how to treat it, please check out the other video on my channel where I discuss everything that you need to know about eczema in kids. I'd also suggest that you speak to your pharmacist if you think that your child has eczema, as they can recommend some over-the-counter creams such as emollients, which can help with this. Now, if it can't be managed at home, they'll suggest that you go and see your child's doctor. Now, it's really important to note that eczema can affect anyone of any skin type, which is why I'm including these photos here. Now, if you notice raised itchy spots or patches, these can be caused by an allergic reaction, and this rash is known as hives. Now, hives can usually be treated at home, but if they're swelling around your child's mouth or if they're struggling to breathe, this could indicate a serious allergic reaction, which is called anaphylaxis. Now, this can be life-threatening, so it's really important that if they have this swelling, especially around the lips or the mouth, you get immediate medical attention. Now, if you've noticed an itchy, round rash that can appear dry and ring-shaped, this could be ringworm, and it looks like this. Now, the patch may look red, pink, silver, or darker than the surrounding skin. Now, ringworm is caused by a fungal infection, and it can usually be treated at home by using antifungal creams, which are available from the pharmacy. Again, for a full video on ringworm, please check out the other video on this channel, which contains much more detail. Now, the next common cause of a rash in children is chickenpox, which typically looks like small, itchy spots that then turn into blisters and scabs. Again, I've made another video of this elsewhere on the channel, but chickenpox can usually be treated at home with rest, fluids, and pain relief, and keeping the skin cool and preventing scratching can also help manage symptoms and help to avoid scarring of the skin. Another common issue often seen in children are sores or blisters that burst and leave crusty, golden brown patches, which could be impetigo. Now, this is an infection, and the sores or blisters can get itchy, bigger, and spread to the other parts of the body. Now, I'd suggest that if you think your child has impetigo, you speak to your pharmacist, because they'll need treatment for it to help it stop spreading. If your child does have impetigo, you should also avoid sharing towels because it can spread very easily, and try to help them avoid picking or scratching it by keeping their fingernails short. Next is scabies. This usually presents as very itchy raised spots, and it could be caused by tiny mites that burrow into the skin. There may be raised lines with a dot at one end, often first appearing between the fingers. Now, scabies can usually be treated again at home with prescribed lotions or creams from your doctor. Next are tiny spots on a baby's face. These are called milia, which often appear when they're a few days old. Milia may appear white or yellow depending on your baby's skin type, and they usually go away within a few weeks and they don't need treatment. treatment. Again, there's a whole video on Milia elsewhere on this channel. Next, you might have noticed red, yellow and white spots, which can appear on babies when they're born. This is called Erythema Toxicum. They usually appear on the face, the body, upper arms and the thighs. Now, the rash can disappear and reappear, and it should get better in a few weeks without the need for any treatment. Next, small, firm, raised spots could be Molluscum Contagiosum, and they look like this. The spots can be the same colour as the surrounding skin, darker than the surrounding skin, or they can be pink in appearance. Now, you can usually treat Molluscum Contagiosum at home, and for more information on this specific skin rash, please check out the links in the description box of this video, where I've included much more on them. Now, another common problem for a rash in your baby is nappy or diaper rash, and typically you'll notice that your baby has a red and sore bottom, but it can also affect the groin area more generally. Now, nappy rash can usually be treated at home by keeping the area clean and dry and using nappy rash creams, and try to make sure that you regularly change your child's nappy or diaper so that it's dry and they aren't sitting for long periods of time in a wet nappy. Now, spots that appear on a baby's cheeks, nose or forehead within a month after birth could be baby acne. You don't need to treat baby acne because it usually gets better after a few weeks or months. Yellow or white, greasy, scaly patches on your baby's scalp could be something called cradle cap. Cradle cap can again usually be treated at home by gently washing the scalp with baby shampoo and using a soft brush to remove the scales. Now, another cause of rash on the face and body is something called scarlet fever. This is caused by a bacterial infection. In scarlet fever, you might notice a rash of small raised bumps that feels rough, like sandpaper. Now, if you think your child has got scarlet fever, you should speak to your health provider, as it usually requires antibiotic treatment. Another important condition to be aware of that causes a rash in children is measles. Now, this usually causes a spotty rash which appears in the head or neck and spreads to the rest of the body, but it can appear anywhere. Now, measles is caused by a viral infection and it can be prevented by vaccination. Now, it's really important that you speak to your health provider if you think that your child has measles. Treatment for measles in children typically involves rest, fluids, and pain relief, but medical advice is essential due to potential complications that could arise. Finally, when should you seek urgent medical attention if your child has a rash? Well, the NHS recommends that you should seek urgent medical attention if your child is unwell with a rash and has got any of these symptoms. So a stiff neck, if they're very bothered by light, they seem to be confused, they've got a rash and a high temperature, meaning greater than 38 degrees C or 100.4 degrees Fahrenheit, they've got difficulty breathing, so in this case you might notice grunting noises or their tummy sucking under their ribs, breathlessness, or if they're breathing very fast. Now, it's really important that your child sees a doctor urgently if they have a rash that looks like small bruises or bleeding under the skin and it doesn't fade when you press a glass against it like this, because this could indicate a serious infection like meningitis. Finally, if their skin, lips or tongue look pale, blue, grey or blotchy, then urgent medical attention should be sought. It's also important to remember that on brown and black skin, it may be easier to see the rash or colour changes on the soles of the feet, the palms, the lips, the tongue, as well as inside the eyelids.